Well, just a day after President Obama and other world leaders called on Syria's president to step down, Syrian troops continued their crackdown, firing on protesters today. CNN's Arwa Damon is there in the region. She's following the developments from Beirut, Lebanon. Arwa.
Kara, many people were saying that perhaps Friday would be a test. If, in fact, the government had been claiming that it had ended military and security operations, would it then allow peaceful demonstrations to take place? What we are being told from the local coordination committees and network of activists is that at least 15 people have been killed when they say Syrian security forces fired at them in various parts of the country as they were trying to demonstrate following Friday prayers. Now, the bulk of these casualties happened in the southern province of Daraa, and there we are being told this area has been under effective military occupation since April. The main city, people can't go out and demonstrate there because of the heavy security presence, so what they've been doing has been demonstrating in various towns. Those towns coming under heavy attack. Activists are saying that it is because the Syrian security forces are trying to squash anyone who dares go out, anyone who dares speak against them. And now they have decided to refocus on the province of Daraa, Kira.
So here's my, and I asked you this yesterday, and I want to get your take today, as we've seen these, the reaction toward the protesters, is U.S. sanctions and the demands for al-Assad to step down. It hasn't had any impact thus far. What do you think going forward?
Well, Kira, until other countries really jump on board, until this coalition is broadened, I don't think it is going to have any sort of an impact. The Russians have already come out and have said that Assad should be given more time. They've effectively really served to boost the Syrian regime's cause and its morale to a certain degree, because it now knows that it still continues to have a fairly solid ally in Russia. The Chinese, for example, as well, haven't spoken out against the Syrians. Turkey, too, appears to be willing to allow the president Assad to have more time as well. So until you really get a strong international consensus, what the U.S. and the Europe decides to do, that's not going to impact this government.
Arwa Damon, live from Beirut. Arwa, thanks.